Let's see. Got a question here. If I ask for the credit contract from the collection agency and they only send my account statements, is it okay to ignore them after that? So, great question. So, let me give you a little bit of context for the other viewers here. So, you get a letter from a debt collector, and typically the first letter will be what's called the 1692G letter, sometimes called the validation letter. You know, say, hey, here's the original creditor, here's how much we say you owe. And then it has this sort of disclaimer on it that says you have 30 days to dispute this in writing with us. And if you do that, we will send you verification. We'll tell you the name of the original creditor, all this information. Now, look, you can dispute anytime, but within these 30 days, if you do a written dispute, then you have exercised your validation rights. So, if you send in a validation type dispute letter to the debt collector, then they have a couple of choices. They get that letter, they can do nothing. And a lot of people are surprised by that. They do not have to respond to you, but doing nothing means no collection. Or they can respond. So that's technically called verifying the debt. They can respond, and now once they respond, they can resume collection activity. So do nothing. Respond by verifying the debt, and we'll come back to that in a second. Or they can get rid of the debt. They can just say, you know what, we're sending it back to the original creditor. Maybe they're a debt buyer. They sell it to somebody else and they wash their hands of it. They don't have to do anything else with it. So the question comes up, well, what do they have to send you when they verify the debt? Well, a lot of that depends on what did you ask them for? What did you dispute? So here's a way I'd like you to think about it. Sometimes we just do kind of a general, generic dispute. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay? Sometimes we get a letter and we're like, I don't know who these people are. So you'd say, look, I dispute this. Send me any proof you've got. And that's fine. And then they just have to respond in kind of a general way. But let's say you get really, really specific and you say, look, I paid this off 6 months ago with check number 1234. Well, now they can't just respond in general and just give you a couple of statements. They've got to go check that out. Like go to the original creditor, go to previous debt collector, whoever it is, and say, hey, was this really paid? Check 1234 for $500 6 months ago. They've got to check that out. So the question is, if I ask for the contract, well, let me answer that a couple different ways. Because sometimes when people say the contract, they mean, I want the contract between me and the original creditor. Okay. Sometimes people say, well, I want the contract between the debt collector and the original creditor. That they don't have to give you. Okay. Now, what if this is a debt buyer, though? They claim to have bought the debt. Is it okay to ask for the purchase agreement between the original creditor and the debt buyer? To me, the answer is yes, you can do that because this debt buyer is saying, we now own your debt. So I'm talking about Midland Funding, Portfolio Recovery, LVNV Funding, those types of companies. They say, we own your debt now. Okay, show me the proof. Give me the purchase agreement. Now, they never will. Okay, they absolutely will not give that to you. Okay, and different judges are going to have sort of varying opinions on whether they have to, but it's something that I would ask them. Now, in terms of the contract between me and the original creditor, that's legitimate to ask for. Just keep in mind for most credit card type situations, there is no sort of signed contract. It's you filled out something online, you called in. And most states say that when they send you the credit card and you use it, you've accepted that contract. Well, what are the terms of the contract? Well, that's going to be the user agreement, user terms and conditions. It's all that kind of fine print that they'll send you. So it's okay to ask for that because you need to know, like, all right, there are late fees in here. What's the basis of those late fees? How do we know how much can be charged? Well, that's going to be in those user term and agreements. So I would ask for that. So going back to the question, if they only send my account statements, is it okay to ignore them after that? I would just follow up with another letter and say, hey, you sent me these statements. Okay, thanks. But I need the contract. I need the user term and conditions, whatever it is. And so keep in mind this whole sort of the debt validation letter and then your response and their response and your response. It's not just a one-time deal. You can go back and forth and you keep asking them and pointing stuff out. Hey, you didn't answer this question. You didn't produce this document.